how do you work in bus? We had a nice lesson about Gutenberg and all the technical stuff that specifically happened. We had quite a long and detailed discussion about the Gutenberg and the technical upgrades that WordPress is going to have in next release. So, and we have been following something really very good sessions since the morning. Now, before I step into my session, I would like to a small trick, or maybe we would like to have a small exercise. See, we all are here due to WordPress, right? And we all love WordPress. So what we are gonna do is, on the count of three, we all gonna say loudly, Jai WordPress. And I'm gonna do a boomerang of that, okay? So on the count of three, we all will be saying loudly, Jai WordPress. Okay, one. Two, three,
Jai WordPress!
एकदम जोर से ठीक है? On the count of three.
मीन उड़ाओ.
One, two, three,
Jai WordPress!
That's nice. Okay. Now, talking about myself, Nikunj Chauhan. I am an interactive strategist at Vishal Web Technologies, and I love to travel and read. I am always up for 30 days challenges. Tea is the fuel for my brain, and you can know more about me at my WordPress.org profile, and you can always visit www.vishal.com to know more. So now, I am going to talk about the content marketing. So let's, what will be there in content marketing in this session? First and the most important thing, how SEO and digital marketing has evolved over the years. Since I am telling you that I have been experiencing, I have been doing SEO since 10 years now. So there are lots of things that has changed, and I'm going to discuss what has changed during these 10 years of time. Then, what is content marketing obviously? How can you master that art and science of content marketing? And most importantly, why content marketing is important? So first thing. Those who has been knowing something about SEO or maybe the digital marketing, they must be knowing that there was a time that SEO was all different thing, and at the current time or at this point of time, SEO is all different. So starting about the content marketing, let's roll back to the February 2011, when there was a major SEO updates. Those two updates were one like Google Panda and another was Penguin. Yes, these two little cute animals, they have completely changed the how SEO has been done. See, I have been doing SEO. There was a time that people, SEO was all about link building, and I was one of those who was used to build 200 or 250 links per day. But now time has completely changed, and if you can find two or five good links in a month, that is also good in current scenario. So these are the things that has changed. And suddenly after 2011, people have started talking about like SEO is dead. There is no future with SEO. Then link building is also dead. So if you can't build links, if you can't do SEO, what will you be doing? Content. Suddenly, all of a sudden, people have started talking about content and the quality of the content. How content affects your digital presence or maybe the online results. So, these are the things. People have started feeling that SEO will no longer give them a result. And always, as human being, we always look for the solutions, or we always look for the alternatives. That okay, now SEO is not working, link building is not working, what will be the future? And they have started adopting different things like paid advertising, social media, some has gone for PPC, some went for the Google AdWords. And according to recent studies, these are the techniques that people are currently following, or maybe the marketers in 2017 has been following. So as you can see, content marketing is always on the top of the content marketers list in 2017. So now, content marketing, everybody is talking about it. that content marketing is the way of doing digital marketing nowadays. But as there are lots of people doing content marketing, and I have been interacting with lots of people who does content marketing, or maybe who are looking to do content marketing, or who have some experience in content marketing, and figure out that there are some myths or maybe misconceptions about content marketing, that what actual content marketing is. And the biggest myth or maybe the misconception that I have found, that was content marketing is able to waste work. So whenever you are talking about content marketing, people will think, okay, I will write a nice blog post, publish that on a certain platform, and then share, and people will start coming to me, and I will have lots of business. No. The truth is that waste blogging is not at all content marketing. Content marketing is a lot more than waste blogging. So, what is content marketing now? But before we discuss content marketing, it also becomes important for us to actually understand what is content. See, what people used to understand by content is the piece of content, or maybe the blog post, or maybe the article. But actually, what the content is, it is an information that is created to present interesting, valuable, and actionable. It is a type of content that is created to provide actionable, valuable, and interesting information to the users. It could be a blog post, it could be a video, it could be a small tweet, it could be a picture, it could be an infograph, or it could be a presentation like this. So now, content marketing. So we know that content is not all about the blogging. There are many types of content available. So now, what is content marketing? You can find lots of definitions if you search for the content marketing definitions. There are lots of definitions available. And this is what Wikipedia. See, content marketing is a form of marketing focused on creating, publishing, and distributing the content. So here, the same thing comes. Creating content, distributing content, and publishing content. So, but in today's era, this was working. This was correct definition. But it was a too old one. In current era, content marketing is not only about creating and distributing content. Content marketing is a lot more than this. So what actual content marketing is? I am telling content throughout the presentation, it does not refer to blog post only. Content throughout the session means the presentation or maybe the information that you have created to drive the actions. So the actual content marketing is all about understanding your audience interest, generating valuable content, delivering the right information in the right time and in a proper format and on a platform that drives the actions. This is all the content marketing is all about. And I have underlined few things that I think are most important in this definition. And to understand these all things clearly, I have differentiated the courses in the four simple steps. Following these four steps will help you master the art of maybe the science of content marketing, and you can definitely be able to drive desired results using these four steps. So this is the first step. Understanding your audience interest. This is the first and the far most important step of content marketing. Whenever you are doing content marketing for any brand, maybe any campaign, understanding what your audience interest is and what they are expecting from you, that becomes the key. And how can you understand your audience interest? Or maybe how can you know that what your audience is expecting from you? And what does understanding your audience interest means? It means that knowing whom you are talking to. See, your audience could be different from industry to industry, campaign to campaign, product to product, or strategy to strategy. So it is essential to know for whom you are creating the content. Then what age, what is the age, gender, education level, language or culture, or maybe the most important, what is the interest of your audience? Where they spend their time online, whether they are doing blog posts, or maybe they are reading blogs, we are more on social media, we are in community platforms where we are spending that time. Doing that becomes very much important. And how? What are the pain points? Whenever you are knowing that your audience pain point is this and that one, they are expecting the solution of certain problems. That helps you create the content that interests them. And that all these things starts with the market research. You need to thoroughly do a detailed market research about your audience in order to identify that what they are expecting from you and how you can get in touch with your audience. And that doing market research will lead us to the second step of the process, that is generating valuable content. Often happens that it has happened to me also that I have created a great post thinking that this post will drive a lot of traffic and conversion. It was a very detailed post, very technical. But unfortunately, I could not get the result that I was expecting. And then I have researched why, what was the cause of that. And then I come to some conclusions that it is not just important to create the content, but it is important to create the content that provides the additional value to your audience. It is essential that your content must provide an additional value to the audience. And what makes your content valuable content? These are the characteristics of valuable content. Blog posts are not the good posts. People are running behind the long posts, long form contents, but long form contents are always not the good contents. Then, when you know that what your audience is looking for, what their interest is, what their pain points are, then only you will be able to provide the solution and generate the content that interests them. And whenever you are writing a content or maybe creating a content, make sure that you never sound over promotional. Because over promotional people are overwhelmed with the advertisement online these days. So nobody likes to have over promotional content. Content creators likes to create the content that gets crawled very very quickly and get the content that gets ranked in search engines. But the thing is that you should not only focus on the search engine, and the other thing is that you should not only focus on the readers only. See, whenever you are focusing on the search engines, you are missing a part that interests the readers. And when you are focusing on the readers only, you might miss the opportunity to get ranked in the search engine. And even if at all you have created a good content, or maybe your content is very much valuable and informative, but if at all it does not get scrubbed by Google or with the search engine, you won't be able to get the best out of it. So make sure that you not only create for the search engine, never create for results only, but create the content that suits the both. Then, the most important thing is always create a content that drives actions. Because the ultimate goal of our whole campaign is to drive action, or maybe the initiate people to do some perform some action. So make sure that you have enough CTAs in your content and have a persuasive language that prompt them to do some action. Third step, choose the right form of the content and the right platform for that content. See, not all type of content works for the all industries. Some industry demands different set of content, other industry demands different type of content. Same in the case of the platforms as well. When you are talking about the Instagrams, it is more about the photographs. When you are talking about the Facebook, you can add photographs, videos, even you can write long posts in the Facebook as well. So, not all content suits to all platforms. So make sure that you choose your type of content wisely and choose an appropriate platform for your content. These are some of the type of the contents that you can choose from. There are blog posts, guest posts, list posts, maybe ebooks, infographics, animated videos, then audio podcast, product demo, reviews, videos. You need to identify that what type of content suits your audience and maybe your requirements, and then identify the platform that is placed for this kind of content and post the content on the proper platform. See, when you have certain...
So these are the type of content that you can choose from, and make sure the right form of content that suits your industry and the platform that suits the content type of content that you have chosen. Social media. This is the key in content marketing nowadays. These are some stats. There are 2.60 million users on the Facebook. Then YouTube has over 1500 million users. And then WhatsApp, Instagram has 700 million users, Twitter has 328 million users. So everybody is on social media nowadays. And 1 out of 3 people are using social media actively in the world now. So you can imagine how big this platform is and how it can be matter of time or maybe the matter of selection when it comes to marketing strategy. See, there are 2.80, these are some stats that says there are 2.80 billion global social media users at the moment. People spend average 135 minutes on social media every day. 95% of the online adults tends to like their favorite brands on social media. So people are getting updates about their social media, about their favorite brands on the social media. Visual content are 40 times more likely to get shared on social media than the normal blog post or maybe the text content. And visual content includes photographs, images, then audio, maybe you can say audio, GIFs, and small animated videos as well. So these are the points that shows the how social media is important. And the other thing that this is where people spend their time on daily basis. People spend 40 minutes daily watching videos, and that shows us how important YouTube, I mean how famous YouTube is among the audience. People spend 35 minutes daily on the Facebook, on Snapchat they be available almost 25 minutes, on Instagram 15 minutes, and people used to use 2 minutes of daily on Twitter. So this shows that we need to check for the content that suits our industry and identify the platform that works best for the type of content that we have chosen. We need a charger. Okay. Your content becomes on the type of your content. So when it is about type of your content, there could be two type of content. One that is seasonal, or maybe the time being content that you can say that maybe the promotional offers or maybe the seasonal content that you have created in order to promote certain campaign, that is
the life of that type
of content is bit small, and there comes the content that is universal or maybe the lifelong. You can keep updating the post and the content and it never gets old. So life of content certainly depends upon the type of your content and timing of the content for your customer's journey. See, you need to identify at which stage your customer is in his customer journey. He could be in an awareness stage, he could be in maybe consideration stage, or maybe he can be in the decision making stage. So you need to identify that where your targeted audience is and what type of content suits or maybe bakes at that point of their
buying journey, and create a content around that. So
Make sure that you understand where your target audience is in their buying journey and create content according to that. And third and the most important thing is the timing of posting blog post or maybe the social media post or maybe the sending an email as well to your target audience. So these are some stats. As we have already discussed, that social media is becoming the biggest
part of the
These are some stats or maybe the timings that you should look for your next marketing campaign on Facebook, Twitter or LinkedIn. So people tend to be more active on Facebook on Sunday, Thursday, Friday and Saturday. Almost at the 9 a.m., 1 p.m. and 3 p.m. These are the studies that showed and that backs the results that the timing that drives the most efficient result on the social media. For the Twitter, the day is the Wednesday and best time to tweet about your product is 12 a.m., 3 p.m. and 5 to 6 p.m. So if you are planning any Twitter campaign, you can certainly look for that campaign. And exactly opposite from the Facebook, for the LinkedIn, Tuesday, Wednesday and Thursday are the days you should look for any campaign. Now, Pinterest, it is Saturday and Sunday. Instagram, Monday, Thursday are the day for Instagram. And always on the Google Plus, just same Twitter, Wednesday, best day to post on Google Plus. So, it's not like that if you post on this time, you are going to get certain results. But it is that if you can you can probably get more accurate result or maybe the more conversion through your campaign. These are some random stats from the content marketing in 2017. So 70% of the user loves to read the blog. So make sure you are publishing your next post that when you post the blog or maybe email the blog during the morning time of your time. One out of every 3 of the world uses the social media regularly. 55% of the online users watch videos every day. There are more than 1 billion blog posts gets published in this number. And that is the reason why this blogging is not only the content marketing nowadays. And almost 864,000 hours of video gets uploaded on YouTube every day. That's a hell of video content. So whenever you are planning your if you are thinking that you should go for video or not, this is the time. This is the time that you should go for the video content, or maybe it could be the animated video, promotional video, product review video, maybe the introduction video, any kind of video, but this is the time to go for the video content. And it's not always required to have professional skills or maybe the that skill set to create a video content. You can always use certain online free tools in order to create some videos. So, how to master content marketing in 4 steps. First is understand your audience's interest, then generate the content that drives the value for them. Then choose the right form of content and the platform, and timing of the content is everything. Now, we know that marketing is important. We somewhat know that how we can do content marketing now. And now, what is the digital marketing prediction going forward in 2018? How bad the world is going, digital marketing world is going. So, this is where marketers are planning to invest in 2018. 61% of the marketers are planning to invest in content creation in 2018. 57% says they will invest more in digital marketing, whereas 54% says they will invest in social media. So in all three parts, the content marketing, content distribution and the social media, that are the three main pillars of the content marketing that are gonna rule in 2018. So, what will be the trends for content marketing in 2018? So, these are my 5 predictions that will be ruling the world in 2018. First, content will be the fuel for buyers and me. Brands will start using content marketing to identify what their target audience is thinking about them and try to fuel them or maybe feed them with the type of content. So, this was the case till the date that marketers used to create the message or maybe the content, they post that content and look for the audience to respond. That might change now. They will first look for the audience interest, then create a message, then select the channel that audience is using and create a content that for that channel. Another one is content personalization. No one likes to have a open-ended email, even if at all you have received any email and say you have just say hey we have you and some you have not even personalized title for email, you might not get open that email. So content personalization will be the key. People are looking for their so content personalization will be the transparency will become also important part. People used to read a lot online nowadays. They are always looking for the review and suggestion. So transparency, when we are saying about transparency, brands will be more clear about what they are saying to their audience, what they expect from their audience, and they will keep on proving their words. And proving how can they prove their words by showing the social media reviews or maybe doing social cause campaigns, and that will be the important part of digital marketing nowadays. And then the interactive visual content. So blog posts will not only will be the type of content that will be used throughout the 2018. Visual content means infographics, but then JPGs and GIFs, animated videos, all these type of content will also be used quite more than ever in 2018.
Last,
lights, camera and video. So this will be the key. Everybody is on YouTube nowadays, and not only on YouTube, even other platforms like Vimeo and all. People are used to see more and more videos. So video will be the most used type of content in 2018 according to the research. So like I have already mentioned that if you are not doing any video work now, this is the time to invest in the video. So these are the five trends which I believe can change the content marketing in 2018. So then I will urge you all to be the part of Swachh Bharat Abhiyan and use the dustbin whenever. Make sure we all use the dustbins. Thank you.
प्रॉब्लम हमेशा आती है क्लाइंट एक बजट लेके आता है जैसे ब्रांड कम्स विद अ बजट ऑफ 10 लाख टू डू अ कंटेंट मार्केटिंग कैंपेन फॉर अ पीरियड ऑफ 3 मंथ्स इसमें से मैं कितना पैसा जनरेशन में लगाऊं और कितना पैसा मैं प्रमोशन में लगाऊं हाउ डू यू डिटरमाइन दैट इज देयर एनी सो आई एम नॉट सेइंग देयर वुड बी अ फार्मूला ऑब्वियसली कोई फार्मूला नहीं होगा इट्स अ नीड टू नो बेसिस और केस टू केस बेसिस बट इज देयर एनीथिंग व्हिच कैन गाइड पीपल टू डिफाइन के मैं इतना पैसा इसमें लगाऊं बिकॉज़ this is what I have faced once, where we spent so much in generating the content that we really didn't have money to promote that.
Like, see, if client comes with the X amount of budget, right, and you need, and you have fixed the goal for that campaign, and you have fixed the timeline, right? So, based on your goal, you can do a research that how much you are gonna get out of the campaign if you put in X amount. For the distribution and the content creation. So there are two types. If your content creation, content distribution becomes tricky when you are creating a common or a generic content. Whenever you have created generic content, distribution and promotion of content, that distribution of that content always get tricky and even costly. But if at all you have created a good content, valuable content, then maybe you need to spend less on the distribution part. Whenever you have created a content that can be shared by the audience easily, that is shareable by the audience, then you don't need to worry more about the distribution part. You have, if you post your content on the right platform and you have created a content that interests the audience and prompt them to share, maybe the content distribution becomes easy. That doesn't mean that it will be done organically. Of course, you need to maybe invest something about the something in the content distribution, but what I would say is that the budget of that distribution may get reduced, or maybe you can play around with that budget of content distribution if you have created a good amount of the content that gets shared easily.
That is after the content distribution.
बिफोर द कॉन्फ्लिक्ट मेरे पास ब्रीफ आता है हाउ डू आई बाइफर्केट द नंबर्स इन दैट लेट्स से आई हैव टू बिल्ड अ वीडियो अ ब्रांड फिल्म फॉर अ ब्रांड एंड देन प्रमोट दैट ब्रांड वो ब्रांड फिल्म बनाने में कितना पैसा लगा वो प्रमोट कितना लगा सो हाउ डू आई फिगर आउट दैट नंबर वो कोई प्रॉब्लम आ रहा है
उसके लिए आप क्या कर सकते हैं एक तो पहले देखेंगे आपकी कंपटीशन क्या कर रही है whenever you will look for the competitor analysis you will always find the trends that is going through and if you will find the trend and analyze the trend you will come to know okay, you cannot go opposite to the trend like if someone is investing x amount or maybe they are putting x efforts in creating the content you cannot simply say that okay I will invest x minus y and in creating content and add that to content distribution. This cannot be done like that way.
How do you get that X? How do you find that X?
You can find that X by doing market research and doing the trends analysis. Let's say, if you have a product and you need to get, or maybe if you have a mobile, let's say you have a mobile app and you need to get the maximum number of installs. The client comes to you, I need to get maximum number of installs for this mobile app, right? So maybe that would be two. You can offer two, three techniques. That you can go for the reward technique. If somebody is installing the app, you give them reward. Like that is the one. The other thing is you can go for the maybe. Some contest kind of thing, or maybe you can try to get that app viral on the social media. So all these three is different thing. Promoting through the social media is different thing. Looking for the reward technique is the different thing. And you will be requiring different type of content for both the type. So you need to identify that which technique you are going for. And what kind of the strategy you are looking to adopt. And first you can figure out what kind of strategy you are looking for. Then you can figure out, okay, if you are going for the social media post, then you need to have this much amount of content for that. And if you are if you want to promote that on the Facebook, then you need to spend average 1,000 rupees or maybe 10,000 rupees daily. So by that way you will be able to figure out certain numbers that how much you need to invest in the content creation and how much you can invest in the content distribution. That you need to first you need to figure out the strategy which strategy you are going to use.
Thank you.
Any other question?
Talking about content marketing, it is predicted that within this year 2018.
360 degree content creation that is going to take over the content part and that is playing integral part even today. So what are your views on that?
Content marketing is always changing. See, 360 degrees content creation is new thing. People have started adopting it and it will be there. See, there was a time when SEO link building was working, then suddenly Google has updated everything and SEO and link building was dead. Then people have started going for the content marketing and social media, and social media gets overwhelmed with the promotional type of post and advertising. Then comes the time of the content marketing, that is guest posting. And people have started doing guest posting for money. So there was a time of guest posting. People used to do that guest posting now as well. But and people are more relying on guest posting as well along with the guest posting nowadays. But recently we have got the maybe news from the Google that they may ban or penalize the site that are going that are doing guest posting just for the sake of leads without any relevancy. So content and digital marketing and SEO is always changing. Guest posting is now today. But it may get stopped tomorrow. Same with the 360 degree content marketing. It is always going to be updates in the content marketing in the form of the content that people use to create and share. See, people have started adopting 360 degree content marketing now. It will come up gradually. So if you are an early adopter, you should go for 360 degree content marketing. And this is coming up. And this is changing the game. How digital marketing and content marketing is working. So if you can adopt that now, this is the best thing. But if not at all, then you have to do that after a certain time. So if you are looking to invest in that, this is the time.
Hello. I have 2 points actually. First, justly I hear from you that link building was dead. I am completely disagree about it because link building was never ever dead. Our domain authority score, our page authority score, our equity links, all is depend upon the link building. Doesn't matter. We are promoting the content by the article, by the blog, by the guest posting, by the blog commenting, but the link building is relevant. Like internal linking structure or rather than the external linking structure, both are very well. And so I'm sorry, but I disagree about it.
This was the time.
Relevant? Perfect, sir. Because if you have like a lot of quality and number of domain, then your authority will increase and the equity links also very beneficial for your site, I think.
Yeah. So link building is dead. What I meant to what was thought behind that was there was a time that people used to build hundreds of links in a day. Right? This is not that is not the case now. So people used to think SEO as a link building only, and that
in India.
Yeah, obviously in India, right?
And my second point, probably lot of trust of the audience and generate the valuable content, but I also want to add the relevancy of the content, complete relevancy of the content. I just want to add you, just because of that, last month we got the Maccabees update of the Google algorithm, and according to Maccabees algorithm, we should go for the relevancy of the content, because then if you have like relevance in the content, then your content will be definitely boost, and your content strategy is right now is relevancy and like to targeted of the audience and the interest of the audience. That's all my 3 points I want to mention you, and I also want to let you know that to engagement of the content on the social media platform is also very beneficial for you, like just not for the like we are like posting in the morning, evening or the afternoon, like the prime hour, you know about it, but the like what is our like engagement of the content, like what is the sharing, likeable, and what is the comment and content promotions and these kind of thing, I think very well important for
certainly those things are. And when you are talking about the relevancy, that is what I have just answered, that people used to do the guest blog for the sake of link building, see, and that is what I have just informed you.
But according to last update, like December last update, the last update directly clarified that the relevancy of the content, the affiliated links, we are normally generated affiliated links, are like according to Google is like down for us. So I think Google is not preoriented like for the like affiliated links and the other things. So that's why I go for the relevant. Come.